We're going to install a 110 outlet, so let's get started. But we shut the breaker off, and now we're just checking with a voltmeter to make sure that the power's off. Now, we're going to go ahead and measure out about 9 inches, and then go ahead and cut it off. And this is going to give us plenty of wire to be able to work with. Okay, now, if you notice, these ears are on these outlets. This is really for a plastic box, so for the industrial application, we're going to be snapping these little Mickey Mouse ears off, so it's going to be able to go inside that box. So we get all four of those off, and then this plastic is also designed to go into the plastic, and we're not going to need these either. So let's go ahead and get those off, and you can see that it fits real nice inside the box. Okay, so we're going to take our wire strippers, and you go ahead and strip off the wires, and just make sure that you're careful not to nick the wire, because, you know, the wire can snap off. Now, this little hole here, a lot of people don't know this, but this actually makes a hook. Kind of cool, huh? So if you put that hook on, then we're going to hook them up to the outlet. Now you'll notice the flathead screwdriver does fit, and if you have to, that works. And a lot of people use a Phillips, and yeah, that works too, but it's not actually designed for those. It's actually designed for this square bit here, and when you use one like this, you're never going to go back. Okay, so now we're going to attach the wire to the lug on the outlet. And this gets a little tricky because the hook needs to go in the same direction that the screw goes in, so it snugs up and tightens. So let's go ahead and get it into the right orientation, and we're going to go ahead and put it onto the lug. And you know, this is a little bit tricky, but once you get it in, you're going to take the pliers, and this is tough at first, takes a little bit of practice, but you want to make sure that thing is snugged tightly around the lug, and it's important for a good quality, good connection. Let's go ahead and take our square bit and tighten it up really nice. All right, now we're going to do the exact same thing to the next lug, and snug it in. And notice the insulation, it doesn't actually go past the outlet, and this is good because we don't want any stray wires in there. So we'll go ahead and snug this one up as well. So the next thing we're going to be doing is we're going to be taking the safety ground and getting that all prepped up. So we've got this copper sleeve that's coated in a lot of places and actually work pretty good. So we're going to take the back of the pliers and we're going to crimp that on nice and tight. Now, I usually take another pair of pliers, and now I'm going to twist this, and this is going to make everything really nice and secure and make sure that the safety ground wires aren't going to come apart in the box. So this is nice and secure at this point. Now we're just going to spread these wires out, and this little hole actually makes the hook. I mean, a lot of folks don't know this, but pretty slick way to do it. Now it's important to put one of the ground wires at the back of the metal box, because if a wire ever did come loose and it touches the metal box, it's going to trip the breaker. If you don't have this wire here, it will not trip the breaker. Now at this point, what we're going to do is we're going to go ahead and put the ground on the portion of the outlet in on the green lug. So we are going to go ahead and tighten it up and snug it up. Now, since this is going to be a double outlet box, we're going to go ahead and just put on another outlet. So you just bring the wires from that outlet over and go ahead and snug it up. The next step is to take electrical tape and we're gonna put on two wraps, or at least two wraps, and this makes sure that there's no lugs that are gonna be inside the box that are gonna be exposed. So if there's any wire that moves around, there's not gonna be exposed wires. So we'll wrap the second outlet in electrical tape so everything's all tidied up. Now it's time to go ahead and put the electrical plate on. So the first thing that you do is you just take a Phillips screwdriver, in this case, and go ahead and tighten it up. And this is going to snug the outlets in nice and tight. Then put nuts and bolts on all four corners. And this makes it really stable. So for a shop, this is going to be much more stable. Okay, now that we have that all buttoned up, it's really important to notice the orientation of the outlets. Now, a lot of people want to put it in this orientation, but look what would happen if a piece of metal were to hit. It's going to hit the positive and negative, and that tape measure is going to be blown in half. Actually, I've seen this happen. So, the idea here is you turn it around for an industrial application. See how it won't hit the positive and the negative? And now that we have this completed, we're going to go ahead and button this job up and put the screws into the corners and get it all put together. So that's basically it. So if you like what I've got here, please like or subscribe.